The San Diego Latino Film Festival has not been able to hold an in-person event for 2 years. But at least this year, the festival will have both virtual screenings and some outdoor gatherings, says founder and director Ethan Bontilo.
Yeah, lucky us, you know, we have beautiful weather here in San Diego, and we have these wonderful drive-in experiences that already exist. And so our opening night, March 11th, is going to be at the South Bay Drive-In. We're so excited to, you know, see the movies on the big screen.
Action!
Tomorrow night's Fronteras program will highlight local filmmakers.
So yeah, I just imagine if you're a local filmmaker and to go out to the drive-in and see your movie on the big screen. I'm really excited about that. To me, that's fantastic. And it goes back to the, you know, why we created the organization in the beginning, right? Is to support local filmmakers, to support young Latino filmmakers in particular. And so to see their movies on the big screen is going to be fantastic.
The majority of films, however, will only be online. Exhibitions manager Moises Esparza says it'll be a diverse showcase.
We try to program with different themes in mind. So there's films about the immigrant experience, there's films about the LGBTQ experience, really just trying to champion as many different perspectives on what it means to be Latinx.
One theme that emerged as he was screening films was about the lingering effects of colonialism. The film 499 by Rodrigo Reyes shatters expectations about what a documentary can be by starting with a conquistador landing on the shores of modern Mexico.
And this one is really form-breaking and astonishing in the way it tells its story. And it explores the idea that colonialism has directly affected the violence in Mexico that's occurring in modern times. So through this kind of like travelogue that this conquistador is embarking upon, you learn about the effects of what these conquistadors did to Mexican society.
The film Blanco on Blanco tackles similar themes, but from a radically different approach.
What's really striking about this film is how it portrays how history is captured and how the way that history is captured is the way we interpret it as actually happening. I would say that Blanco en Blanco is one of the more provocative offerings the festival has to offer, but I encourage audience members to take a chance on it, because the reason to attend a festival in person or virtually is to watch films you would not typically watch, and to watch challenging films and subject matters that are sensitive. And it's part of the festival experience to expand horizons, to become a more learned film goer. So Blanco en Blanco definitely gives audience members the opportunity to kind of embark on a truly film festival-esque journey, I would say.
Part of that festival experience is the online post-film discussions that allow you to ask questions of filmmakers.
I do believe one positive thing this past year is learning how to have these live streams, this communication, the dialogues, because, you know, again, it's not the same thing, but you still feel that sense of connection with the filmmakers, which I think they so badly need it too. They want to see their work out there and they want to discuss their films. So I think we had close to 70 hours of live stream Q&As this past festival. So after the movies, I encourage everyone, it's nightly, there's going to be 2 to 3 Q&As every night. So please enjoy those Q&As. Get onto YouTube, Facebook, and check out the Q&As with the filmmakers. It's pretty fascinating.
So whether you want to expand your horizons or enjoy something familiar, the 28th Annual San Diego Latino Film Festival has something for you. Beth Accomando, KPBS News.